I think in all construction, the need to make buildings durable, have a low carbon footprint, and to be sensitive to wellness of the people that live in the building is very important. Wood wins on just about all those issues.
It's a 4,700 square meter elementary school, and it's a non-combustible construction, mostly made with wood.
We used wood for the formwork. There's a little bit of concrete work in there. We used wood for the structure, so we have glue lamp posts and beams. We have a nail laminated wood deck for all the roof structures.
The roofing assembly ended up ultimately being quite simple, in that we built these panels on site and we just nailed these 2x3s together and they stacked up. And once we had about a 25-foot section by 8-foot section, we just lifted in place with a crane and set it on top of the building. Because of the element of wood, we were able to sequence the project where a lot of activities were happening simultaneously instead of one after the other.
Unlike some of the more common replacement materials which use glues and sealants, you don't have the issue of emittance of VOCs. VOCs have been known to cause indirect quality complaints among occupants of newer buildings. It has a low thermal mass, which means the temperature of the wood at the outside of the building replicates the temperature of the air quite responsively. So it's both a good insulator and it makes us comfortable.
The buildings, it's a high school, it's 35,000 square feet approximately. Wood was used in a number of different ways. We used it structurally to bring some significance to the heart of the school, and one of the largest focal points in the school. There's a lot of warmth that comes from the wood and a lot of variety of colors and natural grains in the material. It's a very welcoming and very inviting material, so it just doesn't feel institutional. I guess those are the ways that it really expresses that sort of the natural material that it is. We have the desire to overcome the challenges of using wood because it's worth it.
The Sauder School of Business is a renewal project and expansion located on the Point Grey campus out of the university. It's comprised of a 55,000 square foot addition, as well as the renewal of the existing buildings that make up the business school. And the project will be completed in 2012. What we needed to do was to come up with a way that we could work in this non-combustible environment, but infuse some warmth, and the only way that we could see doing that was by incorporating wood in this project. One of our design concept key approaches was to create a central atrium between the addition and the existing building, and essentially what we've done is line as much of that atrium with wood. We've got the walls lined, we've got soffits lined, and it all leads up to this leadership center that is totally enveloped in wood. Creating the lobed roof structure for the leadership center, we used kind of a combined column and beam. It's a curved element that springs from a steel saddle that raises it 2 feet above the floors. Durability is always a consideration in any material on a project, and with wood it's no different. And wood is a fantastic material, particularly for surface impact. We line low spaces down with wood. We know it's durable. The only thing that we have to consider is treating the edges. Again, but with more wood, solid wood.
It has the flexibility that it gives to designers of being able to build a large span in the building. High degrees of window space means we have more natural daylight, and as various studies have shown, natural daylight enhances student learning, employee productivity, recovery time in hospital, and also retail sales.
Where do the kids really want to be? They want to be outside. So connecting the inside to the outside was also another kind of important factor in the school. So we've done that in various ways, but again, bringing wood inside the school and treating it as a kind of expressed structural system allowed us to bring kind of that indoor, that nature into the inside of the building.
Forestry itself is what's called a carbon sequesterer. Forestry or trees or plants absorb carbon dioxide. A pound of wood in a tree absorbs about 1.47 pounds of carbon dioxide through its life.
Most often people are taken with the space, and most often they're taken with the location, or most often they're taken by the view. These were the first building tours where you were touring a group of people around and they were actually taken by the material choice.
I think wood combined with management of good air quality, ventilation, and efficient humidity control, all of which wood facilitates, natural daylight, I believe that wood creates a very positive learning environment.
wood makes such a difference in the buildings that we design that we can see afterwards. And you can also just get feedback from the people that use the buildings and own them, that you can see the difference it makes.